Welcome to the Casco Cami Sew Along. I love this cami so much, and I think you're gonna love it too. It's the perfect workout top. It's also perfect for those casual occasions. I plan to make a few for travel and hiking, and maybe even a few for sleep. Plus, there are so many hack options with this design. Let's jump in and talk about sizing. This pattern comes sizes 0 to 34, but this is a knit tank, so you've got some flexibility there, but be sure that you check those finished measurements. Now, this tank is not designed with a ton of negative ease. It's really intended to kind of skim the body. So if you'd like something tighter, consider sizing down. Also note that there are two front bodice pattern pieces included. There's an option for a B cup and a D cup. Today, I'm gonna be making a size 12, which is my standard for our sew along patterns, and I'm gonna use the B cup front. Let's talk about fabric. The most amazing thing is you need very little. Depending on the size and fabric width that you're using, the most that you're gonna need is a yard and a quarter. Today, I am using this lovely knit fabric from Riley Blake. You know I love a nice black and white print, so this is perfect. And this knit blend is actually 95% cotton, 5% spandex, which means that it presses really well. It's going to come in handy when we are doing the binding and the straps on this top. It's also nice and sturdy, so it's got a good recovery with those straps. If you'd like to use a contrast fabric for the binding, like I'm going to do today, you need just a little bit of fabric for that because those pieces are cut on the crosswise grain. You could consider a rib for that if you want something that's super stretchy, or even fold over elastic, and you're gonna get a really super sporty look with that. Consider adding clear elastic into the straps just sandwiched right in that binding to prevent your straps from stretching out if you're worried about that with the fabric you're using. As far as other tools and supplies, this is pretty minimal. I do recommend cutting your fabric with a rotary cutting system. It is so much easier to cut knits flat than with scissors, so give that a go. Also make sure that you have a ballpoint needle on hand for your sewing machine. That's what you want to use when you are sewing knits. Today I'm going to be sewing on this amazing designer Ruby 90 from Husqvarna Viking, and I'm also going to be using my custom ditto form to do some easy fitting, so I'll show you how to do that. Now, I am going to use a serger for the side seams and then switch to the conventional sewing machine for the remaining construction steps. But there are so many ways that you could go with this top, and you can elevate it. You could consider using a twin needle for the binding in the hem, or even use your cover stitch if you really want to get fancy. I'm going to keep it basic today. I'm going to use the conventional sewing machine and use a standard stretch stitch. Let's get started. What you'll need to do is print and tile your pattern, cut your pattern pieces from your fabric, and then join us to construct this cami. All right, let's get rolling. The first thing that we're gonna do is stitch our side seams, and I'm gonna use a serger for that, just so that seam stays nice and stretchy. We've got the front bodice and the back bodice together with right sides facing. Again, I've come in and serged that seam, and now I'm going to start some really simple fit adjustments. At this point, you could try your tank on, but I actually have this really amazing custom ditto form that is designed to be a replica of my body, so it's going to come in super handy here. I'm going to leave my tank wrong side out and just slip it onto my dress form. And this is just a nice point at which to kind of fit check your tank and decide if you want to make any adjustments. So handy to not be doing this right on my body. I do think I'm going to take a little bit off of the side seam here. So I'm just going to come in and pinch a little bit and pin. And again, this is where it comes in handy to have this wrong side out. Just taking a little bit. Again, you can leave it with more ease if you'd like, but I do think I'm gonna use this one for working out, so having a tighter fit will be good. I think I'm gonna leave the hips where they are and just kind of take in from the waist. All right, now I am going to take this off the dress form. Let's see here. And as you can see, I'm just taking in a little bit here. But I will come in with a removable fabric marker and kind of trace this pin line here, and then serge again here to just take a little bit off that side seam. I'm gonna do the same for the opposite side seam, and then we'll be ready to move on to the next step, starting the neckline binding. Okay, let's get started with the binding, and we are gonna start with the neckline first. I've got my short piece of binding here, and I've got it pinned to this front curve of my front bodice neckline. And you'll notice that this piece is quite a bit shorter, and it's intended to be, it kind of draws the neckline in once you finish this step. So I've got these pinned on the outer edges, but the idea is that we're actually going to stretch this neckline binding piece as we sew so that it's the same length as that front neckline curve. All right, just a couple of pins. Some people don't pin during this step, but I like to have a couple of markers. And next I'm gonna take this to the sewing machine and stitch 3/8 of an inch from that raw outer edge. All right, I've got stretch light selected here. This thing is so amazing. I'm gonna come down here to seam, and it has selected for me this amazing stretch stitch. And I am all set up. I've got my ballpoint needle installed, and I'm ready to sew this on. Next up, we're gonna do a little bit of pressing. Sometimes when you're making knit projects, you don't have to press, but for this binding, you'll need to. It'll make it nice and neat. All right, we're gonna work from the wrong side of the front bodice here, and we are gonna press the binding and the seam allowance up and away from this bodice. You can see that this binding is already starting to pull on this neckline just a little bit, and that's what you want. All right. We're gonna fold this raw edge in here to meet the raw edge of the binding and the blouse here. And we're gonna press that again. This is very similar to applying a woven binding. I thought there was maybe a secret trick or something, but it's pretty much the same steps. And depending on what kind of fabric you're working on, this step could be harder or easier. This cotton is so easy to work with. A little bit of steam. And next, just one more step for this pressing. I'm gonna fold this over the edge here, just covering that stitch line from the prior step. Press it. Best to take your time with this part of the process. Okay. And next, I'm going to pin that in place. And I think I'm actually going to pin it in place from the front of the cami. You can do whichever works best for you, but I like to do my top stitching, any stitching that is going to show from the front, just so I can keep an eye on everything. So just pinning that pressed edge. Looking good. All the way out to the edge here. We're gonna use that same stretch stitch on our machine, and we're gonna come in and stitch about 1/8 of an inch in from this folded edge. So I'm gonna do that now. All right, our neckline binding is done. It looks so pretty and perfect. Next, we're going to use the exact same technique to attach the remaining binding and sew the straps. As you can see, my binding piece is pretty wide. So if the knit fabric that you're working with isn't wide enough to cut the full binding piece on the fold, you can just seam two pieces together. And that's what I've done here. Next, I'm going to take that seam or the center point of that binding and match it to the center point on the back of the tank bodice. If you've transferred all your markings correctly, you'll notice that there is a mark on the binding. You can just see it here. You are going to match your transferred marking on the binding to the neckband. That is actually the point at which it crosses this front neckband. So I'm going to pin that in place. And then just as with the neckband piece itself, you'll notice that that piece is a good bit shorter than the actual curve on the garment here. And that's intentional. Again, it kind of cinches it up, but you'll need to stretch that as you stitch those two pieces together. I'm gonna add a few pins here just to kind of take up this excess and evenly distribute it. Shouldn't have to stretch that binding piece too much for this step. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna do the same for the other side. Got my mark here. I'm just gonna match that up with this front edge here. And I am working right sides together. I think one more pin should do it. Next, I'm gonna go to the machine and I'm just using that same stretch stitch that I was using before. Again, working about 3/8 of an inch in from this raw edge. So I'm gonna stitch it down. All right, we have made our first pass on attaching this binding and creating the straps. And the good news is that this process is exactly the same as we used for the neckline binding. One thing that you want to keep in mind when you are attaching this binding and then when you take your next steps to fold it in is you want to make sure that you catch that front edge of the binding on the neckline front in that seam so that you know that you've got it fully encased. Otherwise, you'll have a little opening there and it can be tricky to fix later. So just make sure that your stitch line kind of runs off the edge there and has that full edge caught in the seam. And then you do a little bit of pressing. We're gonna come in and press the binding and the seam allowance up and away from the bodice. Next, we're gonna fold that binding edge in and have those raw edges matching. And then we're gonna encase that seam that we just stitched. I'll show you how that works on the strap and then I'm gonna move along and finish up the rest of the binding. So we've pressed it up and away. We're gonna fold in that raw edge here. Okay. Let's give it a little bit more love. And then we're going to, again, fold that binding over, covering up that seam that we just created. Next, finish up the strap, move your way around the bodice back and finish up the remaining strap. And then we're going to take it to the machine and again, stitch it about 1/8 of an inch in from that fold. Now that your straps and binding are completely sewn, it is time to determine your strap length. And now would be a good time to go ahead and try your tank on. But since I've got my handy dress form here, I just put it on. I've determined how long I want my straps to be, line it up with the pattern markings on the back of the bodice, pin it in place, and then we're just gonna take it to the machine and stitch it right along that stitch line that we used to secure the binding. All right, on to the hemming. This part is easy and you've got a lot of options. You are gonna fold your raw bottom edge 1 inch toward the wrong side of the bodice, give that a nice press, and then stitch that hem. Here you've got options. You could use a twin needle, you could use a zigzag stitch or another stretch stitch on your machine. I've just stuck with the stretch stitch because it's really pretty and it has a lot of stretch built in, which you want at the hem. You could also get fancy with different decorative serger stitches here if you'd like. But the good news is you are done with your cami. I cannot wait to make more tanks using this pattern. I have so many design ideas. I'm thinking about adding some paneling, maybe some mesh, maybe a peplum. It would be really easy to add rings and hardware to make these straps easily adjustable. You could add a shelf bra, lengthen the hemline into an easy dress or nightgown, or even make some matching biker shorts, which is what I think that I'm gonna do. I hope you had fun today sewing the Casco Cami with me. Be sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for all sewing all the time. Thanks again.